Hi, I'm Andrew Linez.
I'm Adrian Kodamredi.
Our third team member, Sachin, couldn't make it because he's out of town.
We are Team Rabbit Ears, and this is our entry into the RFNoC and Vivado HLS challenge. In this video, we will briefly specify the hardware and software tools used, provide an overview of the blocks we develop, demonstrate designing an RFNoC application with our blocks, and finally show the results of our application.
Hardware tools used in this video include a commodity HDTV antenna, this one's from Radio Shack, and a USRP X310. The software tools used are UHD drivers for the USRP, Ubuntu 16.04.1, Vivado HLS 2015.4, RFNoC, GNU Radio, and VLC Media Player.
When deciding on an application for this challenge, we figured the ATSC receiver would be a perfect fit. We knew it would be a fun and interesting, and our work could be demonstrated by the tangible deliverable of video playback.
The decision on which blocks to port from GNU Radio's software version of the ATSC receiver into RFNoC hinged on two factors, front-end proximity and bottlenecks.
Our RFNoC ported blocks from the front end are as follows. RX filter cleans out inter-symbol interference and cranks up data resolution. FPLL reduces phase noise for carrier acquisition. DC blocker reduces DC bias. And AGC adjusts amplitudes to be within a desired range. We've also combined the first pair and last pair of blocks for reasons that will be discussed later. Right now we're running Control Port Performance Monitor against the software receiver. And the primary runtime consumer is from Viterbi decoder, and secondary is from Reed Solomon decoder. Hence, we ported those blocks into RFNoC. The interleaver was selected because it attaches between the Viterbi and Reed Solomon decoders. Those three blocks decode forward error correction encoded by the transmitter. D-pad was targeted as the first block to complete the RFNoC workflow due to its simplicity. It strips extraneous bytes, leaving an MPEG video file as the final output. Our blocks plug and play into the GNU Radio GRDTV module's ATSC receiver blocks. FIFOs are needed where data rates change from software to hardware, along with a UHD instance. In a two-stage process, we must first capture a live signal through the DDC into a file. Then, that file is fed as an input to the rest of the receiver. These two stages will be condensable into one in future revisions. To work around the X310's 10 custom block limit, we combined RX filter with FPLL and DC blocker with AGC so more blocks could fit in a single FPGA image. It's also possible to run those two blocks decoupled into four, as shown in this configuration. So let's capture a live signal from over the air. There's the capture file. We'll let that accumulate data. Now we process that file through our blocks. Execute the flow graph and here is the output being generated.
In our original proposal, we expected to develop only four blocks. Month into the project, we adopted into a shotgun approach by selecting many more blocks to port into RFNoC with hopes of hitting a bullseye. With Viterbi being the largest resource consumer and bottleneck in software, and on hardware version achieving a throughput that exceeds its software equivalent, it can be considered that a bullseye was hit. Multiple other blocks struck right around the mark. We have exceeded our original expectation by developing 10 blocks instead of 4, and we have achieved video playback. We hope you enjoyed the presentation as much as we have enjoyed taking on this challenge.